one, rule number one, you gotta wait till the boss is ready. Yes, thank you, Bobby. This year's Dead Dog Creed. We're down here at the Union Park Tavern. Happy to be here as always. Playing all the oldies and the goodies today. And thinking a couple of new ones. This one is actually called New Songs. But for one of the older ones, we're going to play it. But it still stands tall and stands true. To this day, new songs. When they stop going down, it's hard to tell. For a showdown here, I think, with Dad, Garrett, and the Outlaws, maybe. When I went home to Tracy's house, and I was sitting there trying to be quiet and have a couple of beers and get high, and the kitchen sink was dripping. The next thing I knew, I realized that I was thinking in time to the drips from the sink, you know?
Are you sure it was the kitchen sink?
Pretty sure. You never know. You know, hold on a second. It just goes to show you never know where the inspiration for a song may come from. Take these things for example. Look at this. Here I am. I can't even do a show without this damn thing coming out at some point. You know, and well, it is. Thank goodness. It wasn't running when y'all started because y'all jumped the gun on me. What's going on? So anyhow, so I had, when I was the last guy on the block to get one of these, I used my flip phone for years. I kind of miss my flip phone still. All I do on this thing is I watch stupid kitty videos and puppy videos. And And porn, yeah, right. I take lots of pictures with it, but I hate talking on the phone, you know. But then one day I had to make a phone call. And that's, you know.
He had to ask a 14-year-old how to use it.
That's when it hit me. So, like every good songwriter,
usually you have one
that said there had to be a song about using my smartphone as a phone.
Thank you.
sit right here, have another beer, think about the days gone by. I think about me and you and all the hell that you put me through. Yeah, think I might get high. It's quite alright. Been a long while since I get a ticket all the way. Took the good, I took the bad. You took everything that I had. Now there's nothing left to say. It's all over but the crime. It's all over but the sigh. It's all over, but you were out here about the way things went down. I won't be back.
Yes, you see, you and me.
This one is too. It's horrifying and heartbreaking. I believe what they call it is a fine mess. Kind of like my guitar right now. It's a fine mess of out of tune. Oh, there it is. Oh, it's the G string. I've always had problems with G string. Bed. By the way, lately I've been calling myself the doctor.
Doctor or what?
Hey, Pat, a quick question for you. How come either people are giving you hugs and kisses or flipping you off? It's like there's no in between.
Because I'm a love-hate kind of guy. You either love me or hate me.
Or we love you.
Right? Same difference. Hey, not everybody gets serenaded when they poop. You should feel special.
I was special. It lasted an hour and a half.
Does know best, I guess. I ain't seen one in 20 years. Go to see the doctor who's gonna tell me I got a year to live. That won't be no fun. You know, because that, because I ain't hardly lived in a while and starting to live again, life is good. You know, they shut us down for a year. They tried to shut us down for more, but the facts are coming out, the truth is coming out, and there's nothing they can do to stop the train from leaving the station. And, you know, I was going somewhere with this. Maybe I should just have a drink. I was going to say, you know, because, you know, you can die from lots of things. You know, and people die from things every day, and that don't make it okay. But dying without living, that just don't pay. I mentioned the KCDC sessions earlier. How you doing, my brother? Fucking living the dream, my man. Living the dream. I dream low. I dream low. I set the bar real low. You know, which y'all should, you know? You gotta set the bar low for happiness. Because, you know, cause a lot of people run around miserable about shit that they ain't got no control over when they should be happy. You know, you got a roof over your head. You got change in a bowl on your dresser. You should be happy because you're richer than 75% of the world's population. If you got some quarters sitting in a bowl on your dresser that you don't need to feed yourself. You know, so amen to that. Life is good. Amen. Out here. All right, Terry's turn. All right, hey, I mentioned the KCDC sessions. This is going. As a matter of fact, when I was going to school, I went to school.
Holy crap.
You know, I ain't too cool for school. Although sometimes I am a little bit like school on a Saturday.
Yeah,
no class.
Pat. What's KCDC exactly?
Oh, well, the Kenosha County Department of Corrections. You can tell this guy's a straight arrow. You don't even know what KCDC is.
I've never been there.
I'm a little surprised he even hangs out with me. But it's funny you should say that. When I did have this idea for doing an album called Back in Orange. I was going to call the band KCDC, and then do a whole album called Back in Orange. And I'm going to have a song called You Shook the Whole Dorm Down.
What's your number?
So anyhow. Thank God I never did that, because that's just ridiculous. But anyhow, so this one's about the slamming of the door. You know, when you hear that door go behind you the first time, it just sends chills up and down your spine. And then, after a while, you get immune to it, but the slamming of the door. This guy needs some nicotine.
Yo, where you going, brother?
He's gonna go float in
the floor. Yo.
You know me. I gotta go smoke.
We got a song left here. Come on.
Smoke it.
All right.
Y'all gonna have to play that one by yourself.
All right. I'd like to, anybody got a lighter? Anybody got a lighter out there?
Yeah, I got a light.
Give me a
light. Your butt in my face.
That's a match. Thank you, baby.
Talk to that boy.
Thank you.
So how many letters do you have in your pocket now?
Let's see, six kids, six letters.
He does a lot of light work.
I think it's time to retire that one to get a little better.
He's got more letters than any non-smoker I've ever seen.
He's smoking none of them.
Thank you.
Pat's coming up here by doing a couple solo hits.
Solo?
Solo hits?
The chart topping hits.
Oh, everybody always wants me to sing solo. Solo, they can't hear me.
Thank you!
Another request I get all the time is Over the Hills and Far Away. Can you sing Over the Hills and Far Away? Hey, how about Dead Dog Creek, man? These guys are fantastic. It took me 27 years to put this band together. You know, when I was younger, I had aspirations of being a star. And I went down to Nashville. I was on this TV show down in Nashville a couple of times. There's this video proof, it's up on YouTube, it's pretty hilarious. You wanna see something funny? You wanna see Pat Garrett, 21 years old, smashed off his ass on fucking worldwide satellite television. It's on YouTube. But they offered me a record contract, recording contract. And they said, man, you know, we really like what you got going on. We like the way you look. We like the way you sing. We like the way you carry yourself. She said, we would love to get you down here. And they slapped this big trapper keeper. Is that still a term, trapper keeper? They slapped this big trapper keeper down on the table and they said, you can record any of the songs in this book. We'll put a band behind you. We'll set you up. And I said, but man, I write my own fucking songs. Yeah, I didn't know, I was young and naive, I didn't know that you don't make it in Nashville on your own songs. You gotta play the songs that the proven hit songwriters wrote, you know? So I said no thanks, and I came back home, and I started the County Roads. That's right.
Now you play pool,
Oh yeah, now I serenade people while they're pooping for tips. For free beer. All right. There used to be a lot of cool bars out in the country that I used to go to. Matter of fact, when I was on that show down in Nashville, the song I sang to win my spot on that television show, I wrote while I was walking through a cornfield on my way over to Chrysler's Lagoon out in Pleasant Prairie. And I wrote that song on the way, and I sat there and I sang that song about 72 times that day. I showed up with $5. I left drunk with a pack of smokes and $32 in my pocket. And the next day I went and sang that song I wrote for this Nashville person.
I don't know.
Anyhow, I digress. But I do love to drink beer, and you know, a lot of people, they always, well, hey man, can I get a smoke? Well, of course you can get a smoke. Hey man, can I get a beer? Well, of course you can get a beer. You know, there was a time when I didn't have nothing, and all my friends fed me cigarettes and beers, and I'm going to feed cigarettes and beers to everybody I can, you know, because one of these days I'm going to need a beer again, and somebody's going to buy me a beer, because beer is the gift that keeps on giving, right? Hey, but at least I got an excuse.
No, you got beer.
Same difference. So, well, I guess maybe I should just let the music do the talking. It's a gift that keeps on giving, giving life a bit more worth living, popping tops down and suds, having fun. It's all in St. Earl's Club, and over at my brother's pub, and Esposito's good for a tall, cold one. We'll stop at the hour and hour crossing, fly out by the airport and say hello to Jody if you would. Cause bartenders are man's best friend. Tip a ride, come again. If there keeps on giving, going good. Falling at the starlight, Cordy's is on the rack, Wood Nickel's just above the line. And if you dare to venture there, Illinois has its fair share, jumping two joints on the other side. Yeah, I prefer to stick around, toss them down in my hometown, drink of all this great Wisconsin beer. Cause cheeseheads have a special tailored on, especially growing man, yeah. Gift that keeps on giving is living here. The gift that keeps on giving, a little bit more living. Just ask my friends down at the local club. They'll tell you it's all the same from the county fair to the bowling lane. Saturdays out at the Wookiee Pub. Well, the Chrysler's and Bohots are friends. I sure would like to see you again, but they close the doors for goodness to blame. But there's plenty more to serve cold brew where you stop popping. Gift that keeps on giving, give me a hand. It's the gift that keeps on giving, giving out a bit more worth living. Popping tops, now that sun's in heaven. Yeah, we all enjoy a drink or three. some company. I'll buy this round, you'll get the next one. And I gladly pay you Tuesday for a Coors Light today. You know, probably the reason why I couldn't make it to Nashville as a songwriter is because I sing about all this local shit that nobody gets but you guys.
We get it! Uh-oh, the beer is empty! It's empty! Cars Light,
please! I did write a song about Las Vegas once. Yeah, when I was 19 years old. Yeah, this is pre-Nashville. I got a job doing kitchens with a fella, and he ended up becoming the Clark County Fire Marshal. And so when he moved out to Las Vegas to be the Clark County Fire Marshal, he paid me to drive his RV out there. And so I grabbed my brother Robert, and we took off out to Las Vegas in an RV with an 18-foot trailer with a pickup truck on it. There was about 72 rifles and shotguns, and man, yeah, we were rolling dirty all across the USA. Taking that RV, going up the mountain, it was everything to do to go 5 miles an hour. Coming down the mountain to keep it under 60 was everything you do too. But we made it out there. And so I went out, and I don't gamble. So I'm just happy that we're hanging out. They got cheap beers. So I'm drinking the cheap beers, but then I see these people, they're gambling, and they're bringing in their drinks for free. And they're like, oh yeah, when you gamble, you get your drinks for free. I was like, really? So I threw a 20 in the machine and I started gambling. And the lady came up, she said, would you like a drink? And I was like, yes, ma'am. I would like a Coors Light. And she brought me that Coors Light bag and she was at $7.50. I thought I was gambling, I drank for free, right? So anyhow, oh, I couldn't help myself. Then I went back to the RV and I grabbed my guitar. That's another story. But I wrote this one that night. Well, Cheryl Cole left Las Vegas. I think I know the reason why. It's hotter than fuck and the bars all suck. Prices are all sky. Never going back to Las Vegas, long as I'm alive. That's one of them songs you don't hear me play too much because I drop F-bombs in them stuff. I have some songs that are technically not real politically correct. You know, one time I got hired to sing at my mom's church. I got hired to sing at my mom's church for Christmas. So I spent a couple of weeks learning Away in a Manger and God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen and Silent Night. And I learned all these Christmas songs and I went up there and I'm sweating. And I'm scared, you know. And then the little old ladies, they were digging at it. My mom comes out of the kitchen and she says, "Pat Garrett, play the Jerry Springer song." I said, "Mom, this is church."
Yes, sir.
So I played the Jerry Springer song and all the little old ladies, they really liked it. I was pretty sure I was gonna get struck down. So let's go with it. The Jerry Springer song. Good to see you, my friend, as always. So that's six pack set with the gold team. Got men dressing up like women, women dressing up like men. And he's got a couple of in-betweens, they got both parts hanging off them. And a tattooed bra with the piercings coming out everywhere. I had to give up dating since Jerry went on the air. This one slept with her brother, another with her husband's best friend. Whole string of guys hate to be where they been, but Lord, I get so lonesome, guess I am to wait, as I walk some Jerry Springer, and I'm afraid today. I walk Jerry Springer, and it's had an effect on me. I lost faith in the modern woman, blame it all on Jerry. But I want Jerry Springer, and I'm afraid to date. Well, party if I could do it, or 90210. Melrose Place could take the cake, there's a lot of whores on that show. Lord, we all know that's drama, we all know that's fake. But I want Jerry Springer, and I'm afraid to date. Song I played all night. This one's a good one, and y'all should know it, and I need you to help me along with it, because sometimes I forget the words. But this is one of the first songs I ever learned on the guitar, because when I was a young kid, and I'd go to the bar with my dad a lot, I grew up on a bar stool, and my life consisted of quarters for the jukebox and Polo sausages, pickled Polo sausages. Oh, I'd eat those things like they was going out of style. And this song always stuck with me, became part of my shit. And you know, I started playing this song so much, And there was actually this beautiful young blonde girl who was a musician that told me one
whoa,
night.
Whoa.
We're living it. Listen, I'm talking 20 something, 30 years ago. She told me that this is her favorite song I ever wrote.
Ever?
And I said, thank you.
Wasn't the pooping song?
Because everybody knows that, well, I didn't write this one. I thought everybody knew it, but apparently she didn't. But this is a good one. This one's going to bring us back around. And then I think that Dog Creek's coming back. So going back to the I like beer story. So when she told me that was the favorite song I ever wrote, and I illegally claimed that I said thank you. But that night I decided maybe perhaps it was time that I wrote my own song, my own ode to the fermented beverage. Oh yeah.
Uh-oh, he's empty. Son of a bitch!
So I not only like beer. I like beer too much. Well, last night I did me some drinking.
Oh,
I did.
It's okay.
Well, this is the first song off the KCDC Sessions. You know, matter of fact, a fella tried to steal this song from me before I even got out.
KCDC?
Yeah, what does that mean? It's Keith's Correctional
Detention Center!
Deck chair.
So when you hear that door slam behind you for the first time. The second time doesn't hurt as bad as the first time. I was all alone in a darkened corner.
What's
his name, man? On a silent steel bunk bed. I made a good look at my new home. Everywhere I lay my head. And then I looked at my new neighbors. Black, white, red, yellow, and brown. I told myself I'd make some friends. And then I laid myself back down. Thank you. sessions too. This is the last song in the rock opera known as the Kids. I don't know. Sure.
How's it going, Jim?
Thank you.
All songs written by Parrot Garrett, right here.
All right, I see a bunch of fellas out here now that I've been to the fire. Y'all remember the Wooden Pinup, and y'all remember the Wooden Pinup bus. So enough said. Let's just get into it.
Thank you.
Garrett said I was the cute one. All the boys that hung around with his son. Now she's saying I'm the best she ever had. Better than my brother. Better than your dad. But she been leaving these messages on my answer. My girlfriend, when she packed up, she went the same.
Yeah.
Phil Schiavi's favorite song. I don't know where to put it in. Yeah.
Thank you.
Said he was gonna make it today. Where the hell is he?
I'll see him on the
I've been singing about this line for 20 years. Been there, done that, got the t-shirt.
Oh.
show if you don't play a couple love songs. So I wrote this one for some crazy bitch. I don't know what her name was. This ain't no place. Holy Christ, did you know? Rooted. God's country. It's great, man. Bring it every day. Look, I want to live out there without it. Cause I'm around a little while when I'm born. Most time is the thing I ever thought. Everybody know.
I'm going to go to the next one.